300,000 more. My grandfather's clock was too tall for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by half than the old man himself, though it weighed not a penny weight more. It was bought on the morn of the day that he was born. It was always his treasure and pride, but it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, his life's seconds numbering. It stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. In watching its pendulum swing to and fro, many hours I spent while a boy. And in childhood and manhood, the clock seemed to know and to share both his grief and his joys. For it struck 24 when he entered at the door with a blooming and beautiful bride. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. Rang an alarm in the dead of the night, an alarm that had never been rung. And we knew that his spirit was pluming for flight, that his hour of departure had come. Still the clock kept its time with a soft and muffled chime as we silently stood by his side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, his life's seconds numbering. It stopped short, never to go again when the old man died.
Three little maids from school are we, but as a schoolgirl well can be, filled to the brim with girlish glee. Three little maids from school,
everything is a source of fun.
Nobody's safe or we care for none. Life is a joke that's just begun.
Three little maids from school, three little maids whom all unwary come from a lady's seminary, free from a senior's tutelary. Three little maids from school, three little maids from school.
One little maid is a bride, yum yum.
Two little maids in attendance come. Three little maids is the total sum.
Three little maids from school,
from three little maids take one away.
Two little maids remain and they won't have to wait very long, they say.
Three little maids from school,